Too bad we forgot our machetes. We had to do a little bit of bushwhacking to get back to the side of the apartment to observe the entrance of this colony before we got started. Here's the setup. Got our tools laid out on the table so we don't have to get off the ladder to reach them. Got the tarp down, and there's the area we're getting ready to cut into above the window.
The light will kick on.
Thank you.
So that took about 5.5 hours in total, including some of the cleanup. Rick joined us from the Sacramento Area Beekeeping Association. He lives in the Delta, about an hour away from the job site. He came out to observe. It was fun having him out and seeing him. We didn't frame up the brood, and there's a few reasons for that. One being the large amount of drone comb that was in there. They were raising some drones, and they were also storing nectar in the other part of the drone cells. And then as for the worker cells, about 25% of the cells had brood in them. A very small amount was capped, and then the rest of the cells were full of uncapped honey and, or nectar. And this early in the season, it's April 3rd is when we did this job. There's plenty of time for them to build up after this. So I'd rather take away all that comb from them with an unknown amount of varroa and treat them with oxalic acid and then have them start building comb from scratch, basically, from ground up. And then we'll give them some drawn frames of wax as well, but it's gonna be empty, no food or brood in those. And so that way we can control the beginning of the season for them, knowing they've got the best possible start to get ahead of the varroa. Hope you guys enjoyed the vac cam. We'll be doing more of that. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more.